So this is the basically the nitric oxide signaling pathway. Nitric oxide gas signals by binding directly to the enzyme inside the target cell. Although most extracellular signals are hydrophilic molecules that bind to the receptors on the cell surface of the target cell, some signaling molecules are hydrophobic enough and small enough to pass readily across the target cell plasma membrane. Once inside, they directly regulate the activity of a specific intracellular protein. An important and a remarkable example is the gas nitric oxide, and many types of nerve cells use NO gas to signal to their neighbors. So this is the activated nerve terminal which can release acetylcholine molecules, and the endothelial cell possesses a receptor for the acetylcholine. So when the acetylcholine binds to the endothelial cell receptor, it causes the activation of an enzyme called nitric oxide synthase. This nitric oxide synthase can cause deamination of the amino acid arginine to produce nitric oxide. Nitric oxide diffuses out of the cell from where it is produced and into the neighboring cell. It can act only locally because it has a very short life, about 5 to 10 seconds. So when the nitric oxide gas releases out of the endothelial cell, and rapid diffusion of nitric oxide across the membrane of the target cell, it causes the activation of the enzyme called guanylyl cyclase and stimulating the enzyme to produce a small intracellular mediator called cyclic GMP. The cyclic GMP is produced from the GTP. That means when NO molecule binds to the enzyme guanylyl cyclase, this activated guanylyl cyclase can rapidly convert GTP, that is guanosine triphosphate, to cyclic GMP. The rapid increase of cyclic GMP causes the smooth muscle cell relaxation. So this is the contracted form of the smooth muscle cell, and this is the basically the relaxed form of the smooth muscle cell. So in this way, basically the nitric oxide cell signaling pathway causes rapid relaxation of the smooth muscle cells.